Hi, this is Dr. Joe Albano. Today I'm going to answer the question, can anything be done instead of knee replacement? Knee replacement is pretty invasive procedure. I have many patients that will come to see me because they say, I'm not going to have that done to my knee because they've seen the videos on YouTube or they've had friends or family members that have had a bad experience with knee replacement. And bad things can happen with an invasive procedure like that. A lot of times it does work well, but sometimes it doesn't. So an alternative surgically is an arthroscopy. So the surgeon will go in there, flush out all these bad inflammatory proteins, and you can have good temporary relief just by flushing out all these inflammatory proteins that really is the arthritic process. At the same time, unfortunately, the surgeon will go in and trim up any partially torn meniscus or the cartilage that's covering the bones. They'll shave that down or trim it up, especially with the partial meniscectomy. That may not be the best thing. Partial meniscectomy is the gold standard for treatment for meniscal tear nowadays, but there are good studies that show that you don't necessarily have the best outcomes. For instance, there's a couple studies that I know off the top of my head comparing non-operative treatment, physical therapy, things like that. And at 12 months, there's no difference between the people that had the partial meniscectomy and the people who had the non-operative management. Even better than that, there's a couple sham surgery studies out there. Well, what is a sham surgery? So it's a patient who has either had the real procedure, partial meniscectomy, or no procedure, but they think they had one done. The scope was put into the knee, incision was made, but nothing was done. And so really interesting results with that at 12 months, no difference between the people who had the partial meniscectomies and the ones who had the sham surgery. And oh, by the way, we're not done yet. So the people who have partial meniscectomies, we know on the medial compartment that you have 100% increased contact stress on that compartment. If it's the lateral compartment, you have a 300% increased contact stress there. What does that mean? That leads to a sixfold increased risk of future arthritis in that knee just by getting the partial meniscectomy. You also have a threefold increased risk of getting a future knee replacement because you have that partial meniscectomy. So there are other options besides total knee replacement and partial meniscectomy and flushing the knee out. One really good option that we use dextrose to flush the knee out to achieve the same outcome as getting an arthroscopy where you're flushing everything out. A lot of times people will walk out of my office, get to their car, and they'll say, oh yeah, my knee feels better already. Well, it's not going to last, because it didn't cure the arthritis, unfortunately. Yeah, we don't know how to do that yet. But what it does is it beats down these inflammatory proteins, at least temporarily, because they're gone, physically removed. Not all of them, but a lot of them. And then we will do something to help decrease the production of these inflammatory proteins by using platelet-rich plasma from your blood, or fat, or bone marrow. These things really help to heal, and I shouldn't say heal, it doesn't do that. It'll help to manage and diminish the arthritic symptoms so you have less pain and better function. So that's our option that we can use instead of knee replacement or arthroscopy. Thanks. Bye.